The younger a young person starts offending, more likely they'll be caught up in the juvenile justice cycle of offending, back to court, offending, back to court. We want to disrupt that cycle.
Functional family therapy is an evidence-based model that works with children, young people and their families in the homes to bring about change. So for example, we can work with young people who have challenging behaviour at school, in the community or are involved with youth justice.
Kids can end up having strong peer groups that crowd out the influence of families, and so sometimes it's important to work with the family to regain those connections. And it's in that context again where you can actually create changes that will sustain, because we're not just pulling kids out of a community, expecting them to change, and then dropping them back into the same set of circumstances they were in before.
Internationally, this program's been around 40 years in juvenile justice settings as a key treatment for young offenders. UK, United States, Europe have shown strong evidence in relation to this program and demonstrable reductions in offending.
We work with the young person, their family, and anybody who's important to them. And what we do is we get to know them and work on intervening in the negative behaviour pattern.
We had one goal, and our goal was to reunite our family. And that was it. We wanted to make sure our family was reconnected with.
The focus is on being humble to find out what's going to work for this family in this context with their values and their resources, because we're matching to the family values rather than trying to push our own.
For connectivity, I mean, that's basically what Aboriginal people are all about. Murrumpa means like your connection with the land, the birds, trees, everything within your place where you actually live. It's your connection with that, so that's what Murrumpa is. With FFT, that's what we've got to try and get the family to do, and everyone around is like, it's just connection with everything, and then they can just be involved with the community.
When you see a family who before were kind of a bit distant, who kind of weren't engaging, and now you can see them kind of more comfortable sharing on a couch and just having a laugh and a chat, to be part of that, it's a privilege.
Now our life is very, very different. We're much more confident in what we're doing, and we're connected, and that's the main thing. That was what we wanted, and that's what we got.
This program is necessary for a number of reasons. For government, reports will show that they'll receive a return on $1.40 for every dollar spent involved with this program, in relation to reductions in offending and better functioning families. And the young person wins and the family wins. Young person wins by actually feeling more connected with their family. Family wins because they feel they've got their young person back and be able to actually be that family that we all want them to be.
We've also had success in terms of outcomes with families. So for example, reducing offending rates, increasing engagement with education, and also most importantly, that the young people remain at home and not in remand.
There is a gap in our youth justice system for young people that are entering and having that contact with youth justice. And I think we fill that gap by providing a holistic approach that is family-centred rather than individualistic.
We've got to help the family itself. Just finding their own identity, then they can sort of understand where they're from and what they've got to like work with the rest of the community.
At Anglicare, this is what we do. We work with children, young people and families to help them to make changes so that they can get on and lead healthier and better lives.
It's a proven program. Offending reduces. The KPMG analysis says it's cost effective. And all we now need to do is just get on with it.